Yeah, I feel like we just discovered the secrets of wearing digital fashion, and this technique is super unglamorous, but you guys asked for the video and I'm here to deliver. Hey, it's your girl Steffi, and today we will be talking about how to wear digital fashion. Now, there's many ways of wearing digital fashion and combining it with real life. Certain ways include augmented reality and Photoshop. Today, I will be showing you guys the Photoshop technique. I think it's the best technique so far, just because you can really art direct it and fine tune it to suit the photograph in comparison to augmented reality. You see, I've tried AR, and I have tried augmented reality, but I've yet to find a way to make the lighting really suit the photograph from an AR perspective. There are companies such as DressX and of course 010, and also there's Lens Studio, of course, who utilizes body tracking. So it is possible. There's companies who are already doing augmented reality, body tracks, real-time digital fashion, which I think is awesome. However, I'm still a beginner myself in augmented reality, so I've still got a lot to learn. And if you guys got any tips about digital fashion and wearing it in AR, put it in the comments below. But if not, once I do find a good technique within augmented reality, I will share back to you guys on this channel. All right, so let's show you guys how I wear my digital fashion pieces. We will be wearing a garment that I have already made within Clo3d. My clothing style is always a fusion between streetwear and traditional Chinese patterns, and I feel like that really represents me and my identity. I always start my projects off with a mood board or a research phase, and so I already researched certain poses that I wanted to achieve. I feel like this helps me understand what poses I could try, but also helps the photographer understand my vision as well. So after researching what poses I want to try and of course which locations I want to go to, then it's shoot day and we head over to the location to do the photo shoot. I headed out to London on a weekday because it would definitely be less busy, and that's key. That is key for my photo shoot and also just for my peace of mind. The general idea of this photo shoot is that you want to shoot various poses that you want to achieve and shoot quite a few, and then you will be replicating that pose within 3D with your digital garment. This is my friend Anna, and she will help to take some snaps for me. A key tip is to have arms away from the body if possible and wear something skin tight so that you have less clothes to edit out later. Another key tip is to also, with each location, take a photograph, a panorama, or a 360 photo so that you can bring it back into your 3D program and make it as an HDRI. This means that you will be matching what you have in 3D, the lighting will be the same, hopefully, and that will match also the photograph that you have taken from that day. And yeah, it might be awkward at first because, you know, people might be walking about in public and they might be looking at you thinking, what are they doing here shooting? And what, you know, usually when people do photo shoots, they wear something really extravagant, they wear something really fancy and something to show off, right? Whereas with what I'm wearing for digital fashion, it's usually something plain, something skin tight, and just, you know, most likely it's a crop top and biker shorts, which is pretty normal. But anyways, I do my thing, I do my shoot, and I'm at the point now where I'm actually quite comfortable to do a photo shoot outside in public. But if you are not comfortable shooting in public, then maybe find a location that is more secluded, with less people. Maybe it's in a room where, you know, there's no people except you and the photographer. So it's all about practice. Comes down to practice, and I promise you, it's awkward at first, but it gets easier as you shoot. Here are some of my favorite shots from that location. And you can see we tried a few different poses that I had in mind. Then once we were done with that location, we decided to head over to a different part of town just to change up the scenery and get a few different, I suppose, different pictures, different backgrounds so that we have more content to play with. This place that we headed to did not look like London. It looks like we were abroad somewhere, and that day it was so sunny, it was beautiful, and honestly the scenery was just amazing. So we did the same thing here. We did the shoot, and this is Anna taking some shots of me. As you can see, her lovely direction that she's giving me for the poses. And here are some of the favorites from the second location. Once you have all the shots from your photographs, then it's time to head over to a computer or a laptop. So Anna and I headed to a cafe because one, we needed somewhere to edit and sit down, and two, we were hungry, we were thirsty, and we needed a break after shooting for the whole day. So we are on my laptop, and what I do first is rematch the pose that I've chosen in Daz3D. You want to try and match it as closely as possible just so that in the end you don't need to edit too much in Photoshop. I like to make my avatars change from T-pose to their desired pose via animation, an FBX animation, which I then import into Clo3d. You don't have to do it that way, but it's just my preferred method. Next, we head over to Clo3d, which is where we are going to simulate the garment onto the avatar's new pose. Now, I've already made this garment before the photo shoot just to save some time. And so in Clo3d, we re-simulate the garments into the new avatar pose that we just recreated in Daz3D. After we are happy with the simulation of the garments, we then sort out the UVs, organize them, and make sure they are ready for texturing. Once that is done, then we are ready to texture within Substance Painter. And for me, texturing is the best part in 3D because I can really art direct and create my own style and create my own textures, and it's just a lot of fun. It's almost just like coloring in, like you're doing a coloring book except it's on your 3D model. Once that is done, then we bring everything together in Cinema 4D and connect the textures. This is also where we import that HDRI of that image that we've taken at the location so that the lighting is then the same as the image from that day. And finally, once everything is looking alright, we render it out as a PNG with alpha in Redshift. Now it's the fun part, editing within Photoshop. We bring in that PNG image that we exported and put it on top of our original image that we took from the photoshoot. Then we warp the PNG image so that it fits the body of the photograph. We also had to edit out some shadows just to make the PNG image fit better with the photograph. So yeah, not a really glamorous approach in my opinion, but it works, and I hope this makes a lot of sense to you guys. It's definitely possible if you guys know how to use these 3D programs and also use Clo3d or Marvelous Designer. As I said, this is only one of the ways you can wear digital fashion, right? So I'm hoping for a better technique in the future where it doesn't have to be so laborious, because as you can see, I went through at least 4 to 5 different programs just to get this result. I am really putting my bets onto augmented reality technology to make this a lot easier, where we could just scan using our phone or using glasses, AR glasses, and it will automatically detect your body and also the lighting. For me, the key thing is the lighting, because there is augmented reality body tracking and wearing digital fashion using AR, but it's the lighting which it just totally throws off the illusion that you're actually wearing it, because the lighting doesn't match the real life lighting, which for me as a 3D artist, it really bothers me. But anyhow, I'm sure technology will get better, and I hope you guys have found this video insightful. I know a few of you have been asking me to do this video for a while, so here it is. And I hope this video has not shattered the illusion that of how unglamorous this technique is, which it is. At the core of it, it really is just a Photoshop job at the end of the day, and just matching it in 3D and comparing it to 2D, but it works. It's one way to wear digital fashion, and I'm looking forward to how it's going to be way easier in the future. I'm going to look back at this video, give it a few years, and I'm going to be like, wow, I really went through like 5 programs just to be able to wear digital fashion. Of course, thank you for watching this video. If you guys got any more questions about digital fashion, then please put it in the comments down below. And yes, I stream every week on a Thursday on Twitch. So if you guys want to see digital fashion creation or the process, or ask me questions live, you know where to be. On Twitch, Thursdays, 7 p.m. Oh, is it 7 p.m.? 8 p.m. 8 p.m. UK time. And lastly, you guys can chat to me on Discord as well. So feel free to join either the 3D educational Discord I've created for anyone who's interested in 3D and want to either share their work or get advice about 3D. Or you guys could join my personal Discord, which I am on pretty much every single day. It is the Imperial Digi Realm Discord. So feel free to message me on there as well. And that is the video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.